Hey everybody, and welcome back to The Binding of Isaac Afterbirth. After last episode, shenanigans, and the Keeper not actually being done, we're going to actually finish the Keeper. Basically, this means that I have to find either a whole bunch of money, actually go for angel rooms, which is probably what's going to end up happening, or get the swallowed penny, and a curse room. These are like main options for getting to Mega Satan, but we also need to be powerful enough to beat him, which is either going to be a chaos card, or just in general being really powerful. This could be interesting. I'll give it a shot. My luck stat is really low, so chances are I won't fire too many tiers like this. Oh, it only fires one tier. Interesting. I'm not sure if I was expecting that or not, but that's what happened. Actually, that's pretty quick for having such a low luck stat. That is actually a free bomb. I will take advantage of that. Now, we're no longer in a rush, so min-maxing is a thing again. And I'm going to do it, because min-maxing is one of the only ways that the Keeper can really pick up too much power. And I can dream. At least I hope I can dream. Alright, no like big curse room, or curse room, no big secret. Whoa, I fired two in one go. That's pretty impressive, I actually think. Ooh, nice key. I don't think that it's particularly, well, I guess now there is. When I entered that room, there wasn't a good candidate for a secret room. Now there is. It's right here. Just gotta watch the red fire. Alright. So I am gonna stop by the shop. I think it's worthwhile. Spider mod is good. The battery is also good. I guess we'll see what becomes. I don't know if I want to bomb this early. I mean, it would be rather easy for me to get everything that I need. If I blow up all the poops and all the fires, I should be able to get more money. We're almost guaranteed enough money at this point. One fire having a coin is likely, plus I still have at least another flip, probably two more flips. No, I've got guaranteed two more flips of my coin. Oh, I've got 2 cents laying on the ground. So yeah, I've got it. Picking up some extra keys is always nice. So the question is, which do I want? The battery. Well, I'll make a decision later. This is good. If I die here, then we at least know that it doesn't really matter which of these that I pick. But I suppose Spider Mod could save me. I suppose it could, but I feel like it won't, or wouldn't. You think you're all that. Ooh, that was kind of close, actually. Give me. Oh, I know I'm getting. Okay, yeah, ball bandages is nice. So the question becomes, do I buy one of those? Because the battery lets me store an extra charge, which is so-so. Spider mod can. Yeah, let's go spider mod. Let's go spider mod. Spider mod will help us. Basically figure out how we're doing. I don't need an arcade, so I don't feel bad about not having 5 cents going down to the next floor. I could not avoid picking that up, unfortunately. So you can't really hurt me. I can't go into there, really. Unless I take damage. And you should be dead here any second. Okay. Multidimensional baby's not the worst. Oh, I just noticed that its subtext is buddy backwards, and then buddy. So it's for him backwards. So, multidimensional baby sits behind you. It literally follows 3 seconds behind your character, and when you fire, it doubles up your tiers. Like, if you... when you fire through it. But it does follow 3 seconds behind you, which makes it a little hard to use. Boss fights where you pan back and forth, like, in the same room, or in the same space, like, back and forth like this, it's a little useful. You can just kind of slowly keep backing up, and it'll follow you, but that's about it. Actually making use of it is challenging. That was lucky. Unfortunately, it reduces our chances of it'll deal with the devil very significantly. This is probably worth it. Alright, chariot. See, now I wish I had a bomb. Yep, now I wish I had a bomb. Dang. Spider-Man is actually taking pretty good care of him. I'm getting a lot of damage in. Now, unfortunately, we got an HP up, but no devil deal. Now, I could go check if there is a bomb, and that might be worth doing in the shop. I can enter shops for free. Oh my gosh, it's Diplopia. Two of clubs doubles my bombs, or gives me two. Really, that's not the secret room. Huh. Well, I'll be damned. Okay, whoopsie, we want this. One of those, anyway. Oh, did I not pay attention to this room? No, that's totally the secret room. It's the only valid secret room location. Ah, dang it, short of where the top secret room is. The top secret room could have made a different room viable. Unfortunate, but true. We do have to get deals, though. Thank you, cube of meat. Cube of meat saved my bacon there, totally. We don't have Sackboy, but suddenly a whole bunch of sacks are appearing. That is a nice find. We're pretty much shop-worthy already. That was very close. These guys are very on point. Alright, there's totally a swastika in the middle of this room. Don't ask me why I decided to notice that right now. Because there's really no relevant reason for that. Probably because... well... probably because I've been paying attention to some of the more liberal media outlets following Trump and his policies. There have been some interesting things in the media. I do know some of the demographics of my channel, who's watching, things like that. But that doesn't actually tell me who's Republican or Democratic or whatnot, so I usually try and stay away from political topics. Mostly because you can sit there and argue things like that forever. Scapular is useless to me. As the Keeper, I can never have half a red heart, therefore I can never benefit from the effects of Scapular. But yeah, I tend to avoid talking about stuff like that on my YouTube channel. Just because, you know, th- There's the only way to actually have a discussion is to have a dialogue, and guess what? We don't actually have much of a dialogue here while I'm talking. You can't ask me questions, talk to me. Now, if I was streaming, maybe it would be more feasible, but not in this case. I'm not streaming. I don't have time to stream, unfortunately. Well, I guess it was, like, premonition-ish. Because sax, I guess? I don't know. Let's see if there's not a better place to bomb. Like, somewhere I could benefit from bombing more. Alright. We'll go all the way around. I don't want to waste bombs if I don't have to. So, Spider-Mod saved my bacon there by slowing him, or by fearing him, I guess, actually. Fool card. Okay, interesting. Yep. Dang it. I should have used the chariot card. Yeah, let's not curse the tower this. Unless Pyro is in the next room over. Okay, I like Tech X. Like, I do. It's a nice item. Well, if we were to find a bunch of money... The only thing that I'm not a huge fan of with Tech X is it's hard for me to tell when it's charged enough that I can release it. I forgot to use my coin. I decimated that room so quickly. Delicious Tech X. Just look at that destruction. PhD would be good to have. Being able to see pills. There are good pills, it's just there's not a lot of them. Well, I might be able to buy it yet. I like bombs. We have quite a few of them. Okay, speed and range. The range doesn't really affect us because Tech X, but the speed, oh my gosh. The speed will make dodging significantly easier. You know, despite having not a lot of luck, well, now we're at -1 luck, not -2 luck. That's a thing. Alright. Don't think that's a viable option because of the poop there. But I don't actually know. Luckily for me, it doesn't particularly matter here. Well, I can solve this problem very quickly. Forever. Secret room could be in a lot of weird places. Like, here it is. Bomb for 5 cents. Pretty worth it. I'm tempted to buy the other, okay, this is top secret rooms, I don't know that. I'm tempted to buy the pill that's in the shop because we've got PhD. It might be worth it. Got a lot of tinted rocks, but... Gotta watch out for that. Alright. Okay, we're officially at neutral luck. You got 3 bombs, I'm willing to give this a shot. Hermit will take us right to the shop. That could be very useful. Hello. I'm going to try this one too. A bunch of flies is something that's not too bad. I will not buy the other pill. Mostly because I've almost got enough money for the shop, for an item in the shop to begin with. And we are continuing to get bombs, so. Forgot to use my pill. I have no idea what this is gonna do. Oh, what? Okay, this seems really good. Like, it just coats the room. Once again, didn't I once again, though, get... This is like, I get Dunce Cap so much with Keeper. It's really quite odd. Just raining death and destruction. Alright, that is probably the secret room. Okay. Infamy is very worth it. I don't know any more bombs. But, oh, that's a double key room. Another bomb. You know, Nightlight's not terrible. Also, it makes Curse of Darkness not a thing. Almost blind myself, though. You can barely see me behind the mask. Now, it's not good for single target damage. That is very true. But it works, and I'm not gonna be able to take this. Yeah, I am. Because it gives me 9 lives. Which to me is worth it. Am I gonna double key room? Probably not. Who am I kidding? I can't resist. So this was 100% worth it. We got 2 keys back. And a whole buttload of money. Matchstick gives us more bombs, presumably. Alright, I think it's time to go. Now I can start taking deals with the devil, so long as I accept the fact that I will be left with 1 coin if I'd ever die. Well, that's the thing. So the Keeper has a 1.2 damage multiplier. I did end up looking it up while discussing it with a friend. And that is actually the 3rd highest, tied with Kane. Judas is, of course, 1.35. You could argue, well, this isn't, body lust isn't really going to be that useful to me. You can argue whether or not you want to argue, or, you know, mention that Dark Judas, whether he's a thing. Okay, well, that was... Once again, I have neutral luck right now. We got 2 luck ups over the course of the game, so I have 0 luck. And I still get a horseman in a tiny room. Just, I feel like that's worth noting. But yeah, it depends whether or not you want to consider Dark Judas a character in terms of comparing damage multipliers, because his damage multiplier is technically 2.0, which is the highest in the game. But yeah, as I said, questionable. It's up to you if you want to consider it or not. And then Judas has 1.35. Azazel actually has a 1.5 damage multiplier. I was not aware it was that high, but it is, so that's a thing. I am rolling in money. I would love money equals power. Doesn't matter when I use my coin now. I mean, out of habit, I'm using it as entering rooms, which is fine, and I don't worry about it too much. But because I only have 1 health, it doesn't matter very much. Nope. Question is if I want to buy this. It means I don't have to spend keys anymore. At least on doors, so sure, let's go for it. I paid 7 cents and I get 5, so basically it's 2 cents. Sure, I'll use money opening doors, but I can use a different trinket now, which is eventually going to be the plan anyway. And I'm rolling in money, so I don't much care. Okay, a blank rune is good. It's an AWAS and another blank rune. Okay, we got vision. Ansys is vision. I guess I'll go ahead and take the trip all the way back down here since we don't care about time. They have those creepy golden eyes. Oh, cool. It's a nightmare room. Forgot I had Sackboy. Okay, I don't have anything against Abel, personally. That was beautiful. Oh, it's a sticky nickel. These are things that we unlocked. Has to be bombed off the floor. I shouldn't be holding my fire key down. Abel actually hurt me there. Okay, what does this do? It has something to do with familiars, but I don't really need the hermit card. It saves me a penny. It would save me a key in the past if I didn't have my current trinket. I actually wonder if it costs me the penny to enter the shop now. Like, I'm actually very curious about that. Alright. Cool. Now we get bombs. Every couple rooms, or so on and so forth. It will drop a bomb. A bomb drop, so it could be a troll bomb, super troll bomb, 1+1 free. There's a couple different options. This is very tempting, and I will probably have to do this. Hey, look, an arcade! That will immediately kill us, but you know what? It saved us some money right there. Or gained us some money. Oh, goody. I almost hit those spikes. Just boom. We are doing some crazy damage. Hello. I do need to pick a floor and, basically every floor I need to not pick up money now. I need to just leave it. Unless I find a solid penny. Which I should probably be blowing stuff up now for it. Also, I technically have infinite money as long as there's a room with combat in it. And that is because I basically now, you can look in the upper left hand at the charge and notice that it is in fact increasing. Money litters every room. You know, I might as well fight the boss. I haven't taken damage yet. This isn't... Okay, it's case 2. That is some damage. Okay, well, let's do this. Guppy Dream. This kills me. However, I then get Magic Mush and I'm up to 2 hearts. Plus, I get a 1.5 damage multiplier and a bigger head. And some other stats. No, I'll... Ooh. Ooh. Bomb's contact has a chance to freeze enemies when my tears hit them. I don't know if I can tell which of the Tech X shots actually does that. I'm not making a one make... eating a one makes you larger pill. Okay, hoping for a cursed room here. or not a curse room, a sacrifice room on this floor. We've still got a couple dead ends. By that I mean two. Okay, so when I fight an angel, I need to not die. That's gonna be the hard part. I want one coin in there for when an angel actually spawns, otherwise I'm gonna have to... Basically, I have to keep coming out. Nope. I feel blessed. Yeah, that's how this is gonna be. This is good. I continue to feel blessed. That's basically one penny for each angel fight. If I hadn't already seen the devil room, I would have gotten a guaranteed angel room. I'm okay with this because I'm two-thirds Skeppy, and I have 9 lives, which means I have a means to acquire Guppy? Hello? Body? I'm gonna leave that there. Just in case, for whatever reason, I'm in the middle of an angel fight and desperately need it. I have it. As a third pickup, basically. Okay, troll bombs, sure. I believe... That trinket's now useless to me anyway, so... I believe this is the closest place with money now. Unfortunately, there's no way to pick up money and dispense at other places. Okay, I'm no longer particularly worried. That would have been a whole bunch of heart drops. Instead, it was a whole bunch of flies, which means we're probably going to insta-kill the second angel. Which is good. Which is very good. We still have a while to go. Now, if I really wanted to... Wow. Boom. Well, we're done here. If I really wanted to, I could just go straight to the dark room. I would rather make an attempt at Guppy. I might as well go collect all the money everywhere now. Wait, why... Why is that... It doesn't constantly recharge... Unless I'm in a room with combat, right? Which room is considered to have combat in it, though? Was it because I stayed in this room? I'm picking up the body so it doesn't show up anywhere else. I'm not sure if I maybe picked up a battery I didn't see. I'm going to forego the coin in the big room. Alright, well, now we can just go. We are pretty darn powerful, though, so... We got a pretty good shot. I think we got a pretty good shot at Mega Satan. That's so much damage. Just like boom. It's crazy. I'm a fan. This build is pretty sweet. I think the Dunce was the correct pick here. Because you fire enough. You fire big enough tiers that small rooms do just get annihilated by everything. Well, unfortunately that's not good enough to replace my use item. I actually really should be using this the correct way now. For some reason, my iframes were just huge. Alright, crawl space. This is a black market? I haven't seen a black market. Oh, I haven't seen a black market in a long time. I can kill myself for this. Do I want to, is the question. What the hell happened? So I can totally kill myself for this. Question is, do I? You're gonna hate me, but I think the answer is yes. So now I only have one heart, or one coin, but the Steam sale, there's so many, just, like, if I get restock. Plus, I've still got a whole bunch of lives. Oops, that was a mistake. Like, we're rolling in consumables, we're rolling in money. Oof. Rune bag. Don't get me wrong, Mulligan's good. Mulligan's still very good. The difference, the big difference, is that I'm aiming for Guppy. And Mulligan is useless when you've got Guppy. Because it's just a more powerful version. Darn. Punch of Hearts, which is just a bunch of flies. Already got that. Rune Bag has some pretty awesome options for us, though, which is why I went for it. We could get a Yara, which opens up big possibilities, especially because we're so shop-bound. Nope. A reroll? Yes. Would I take blank card? Now we're at plus one luck.
Pair throw.
Buying just to get it gone.
Are you a wizard?
This makes it fire at stupid angles. I don't know, I didn't really take it for any particular reason. We could actually do boss rush again. We could do a lot of things. Okay, we might be able to do boss rush. I'll probably take too long on the fight. Yeah, I did already fight. There's a trapdoor here, that's why I'm doing this. Also, I could take more stuff. Wait, why are these soul hearts? That's weird. They should still be red hearts. Probably going to have super greed in here. Okay, we got another luck up. Resistance rune. I'm not going to replace my use item with the pad. Damage up. The crazy thing is I might actually aim for Hush. Okay, there's a possibility of boss rush here. It's already open, so it's not going to close. You know what? I'm crazy. If I die, I lose a life. Big deal. If I win, I get another item. I don't need money. I've got one heart. Daddy Longlegs is... Oh my gosh. You traveled like nuts, man. Now, I don't do as good in this big room. Hello. It's good to know that Mega Fatty's in the fight. Just so much spread damage. Woo. Wow. That's a Gertie. Okay. I do have a panic alges if I'm about to get hit. You stood on the edge, man. Alright. This is one of those times where I could just get hit. But I gotcha. Oh, little horn, you're just easy. Don't know what else is... Okay, make him long. I want the runes gone. That I shouldn't have used. Daddy Longleg's shadow coming at me. For some reason I thought it was a shot. Okay, bombs are dangerous. There you are. The mom's contact effect makes it really nice for Daddy Longlegs. He did not quite die. That was actually very close. That was it. Alright, we got a Yara.
Answers.
Well, off we go, I guess. Do I go for Hush? I think I might. Although, the problem is if I do... If I get Guppy, the answer is yes, 100%. I was not expecting that many.
I can see for.
I don't remember what pill this one is. Oh, are you a wizard? A lot of no fight rooms, which I'm okay with, but just odd. Let's try this way. Almost died there, turns out, because that's red poop. It's a little too bandage. Okay. Bob's cursed, poison bombs. I could have Yared that, it might have been worth it, but I think I'm going to save it for the chest. Curse of the Lost. Well, this is annoying. Beautiful. I'm Guppy. I've unfortunately lost my coin. Oh god, but I can fly now. Oh, that puts me back in here. Why, hello. Empty vessel doesn't actually help me, sadly. Because I can't ever have no hearts on this character, so we'll just stick with this. But I got my coin back. It's another... Oh, okay, so now I've got Curse of the Maze.
I can see forever.
Oh, I should know that. I should have 100% known that that was the Curse of the Maze pill. Oh my gosh, I've got Prothro and Yara. The reason I should know that is because I have PhD, and it would have told me what pill it was, and it technically did. It's just, it was question mark, and my brain automatically assumed. What? That was an Emperor card. Can you Curse of the Maze an Emperor card? Wait. Found my Prithra rune. Oh my gosh, there's just so much going on. I'm 100% lost, also. If you couldn't tell. Which is actually true. With Curse of the Lost and Curse of the Maze, you can never actually know where you are. Basically, you just keep moving. There's a whole bunch of really cool stuff, but I don't have any way of carrying it all around. Crap. It's in here. This was also a mistake. I mean, I'm killing, like, nobody's business. It's not even worth it. Okay, this might be the right way. Another sacrifice room. I tried going up. Dead end. Oh my gosh, more runes. I have like 7 Perthro runes on this floor. There we go. As long as I don't get Curse of the Maze right here. Oh, this is it? I didn't realize. Well, I'm a dummy. So we're going to do all the hard things on the Keeper in one run. Except this time I'm actually going to remember to do the right one. Okay, things I wasn't particularly looking for. Unicorn Horn is tempting. Sorry, I'm gonna be looking for, like, everything here. We might get a black market, it's possible. I'm going to take Rubber Cement. I don't think it does anything. I'm going to take Mom's Perfume. It's Fear Shot. On top of that, it also lowers, it's a tier delay down. Dropped that bomb before I saw this. No black market. It's White Feather? That really can be in here? Crack the Sky. Holy White Death. Unfortunately, I do not have a Perthro. So here's the question. Do I dupe this? I think I do. I think I dupe all these. I think there's no reason not to. Think. Because I could get a Yara rune or something like that. Temperance. Temperance. Yeah, I should do this. While I'm here and doing this. I'm not going to buy. I was really hoping for something else, basically. That's disheartening. I should actually go with the candle. Just for now. Oh, shoot. Well. When he's not on the edge of the wall, this does become a problem, but. A set amount of damage, so if I didn't have Daddy Longlegs, I could have done some setup. But I got this. I gotta no-hit him. I think it's totally possible. The answer to your question is no, this probably was a mistake. But I'm doing so well in this run. that it was hard to not. I wonder if he's immune to that. Dude, I just have so many flies. Like, even if you're dampening my DPS, this has to tear you a new one. There's no way this doesn't. Thank you for giving me more targets. Unfortunately, they are distracting Deadly Longlegs. There's only one attack that can feasibly kill me. I guess I can use the red... Are you just gonna sit there and do this? Bring it! I dare you. I do have to be careful where I am pointing my nightlight. I could create a gap that I cannot actually get through by slowing down tears in a bad pattern. It's possible. Unlikely, but possible. Okay, I literally have the max number of flies. There's no way I don't. My flies will tear your flies apart. I am Guppy Destroyer Worlds. Except for this. This is the attack that can kill me. Because I can't really tell where they are. Victory! Woo! Alright, let's go get our coin. Just in case. Just in case. I have no keys. I don't know why I have no keys. I'm going to need keys. Oh, right, because I used 8 keys on all those chests. So, that was a thing. Now, Fighting Hush didn't actually improve our damage or anything like that. Oh, I can fly. What am I doing? See, don't take that pill. It's already a question mark. I'm so silly. Let me out. I can get up to 99 cents. For no reason. Oh! Gold bomb. And a blank rune. Well, blank rune's gonna get saved unless I actually pick up a Yara. High Priestess I can use on something. Oh, shoot. I need to not do that. Oh, I really? Ugh, I didn't pick this up before, so... That's why it showed up again. It's really trying to tempt me, but I do not have the keys. So, this run, huh? Once again, might as well pick it up. Oh, this is a room. Once again, it's good to be Guppy, Destroyer of Worlds. That's Guppy. Wow, no tinted rock in this room. I still haven't gotten a small rock. Another sacrifice room. This is entertaining, but not very difficult. That's one of those, like, I regret pressing this button buttons. Because usually the buttons are bad. Alright, see, this room might give me trouble, because Mega Fatties can do that insta-jump. Oh, Perthro. Perthro is also a valuable rune. If I don't have a Yara, I might as well have a Perthro. And the question is, I'm going to clear some of the rooms, see if I can get a Yara, because I think a Yara is... I also need keys.
Hagalaz.
It likes being Hagalaz, apparently. Okay, that's good. Still need one more. Boom. Nice. Okay, money. Ooh, what's this? Might as well use it. This is why I like the rune bag. Rune bag, very nice. 10 out of 10 would rune again. Alright. Yeah. Don't need that bomb. I'm sure as hell gonna take it. Ah, okay. Mini boss can always spawn that. Another golden bomb? Okay. There's no reason why I shouldn't find the top secret room. Or the secret room. It is more likely to be here, because it's surrounded by more rooms. Though that does have a small room next to it, so... I do have 5 keys. Oh, well that's nice to see. Another luck. So I think we're at 2 luck now. Which is impressive. Good to see all these keys. No other chests, so we'll go ahead and head down. And Perthro is what we'll be carrying with us. To the chest. Very solid run. Very happy with this run. Curse the Maze is annoying. Unfortunate, but... Oh... And now... Oh, I guess Tractor Beam doesn't really do anything with Tech X. That's unfortunate. I'm actually really sad about that. Ew. Well, we're gonna go try and get more stuff. Which includes more runes and more chests. I was really hoping... Because Tractor Beam puts all your tiers in front of you. Like, all of them. It's a damage up. It does. We already have the 1.5 damage multiplier that provides for Magic Mush, but... Okay, Wide Shot. Don't really know what that does here. Oh gosh, we got Yara. Yeah, I probably should have fought, like, a whole bunch of rooms before I opened those. Would have been more responsible of me. Now, which one is this? It's another Perthro, so we might as well. We're never gonna get a concentration better than that. Death's Touch is a tears down, but a damage up. Not that we particularly need damage ups, but with the damage multipliers... Oh, I should save my... I should... Bust out the Yara. Open all the other chests, but save all the Yaras for that room. I think that's a decent plan. Oh my gosh. Yeah. That's good. Now I'm... Ever. This is only gonna get more shenanigans. Give me more Yara runes. Oh, well that was disappointing. Sure, I'll take a little Steven. As long as we've got a Yara room reserved, it doesn't quite matter. Oh, that's nice. Toxic Shock does a whole bunch of damage when we walk in the room. A new room. Just like this. Go. Go, Dark Bomb. Or Dark Bomb. Ah! Curse of the Maze is being really active right now. Sure, speed up pill. It was, doesn't really help us or hurt us. Ooh, these small rooms are actually really good. Because all our shots go nuts. Go. Go, ya bub. Alright, we have found boss number one. Star's card is just a teleport. Oh, goody. That's one Yara. That's two Yaras. There's two Yaras in here. Oh my gosh. I'm like, this writes itself. The only downside is that I was silly and didn't like start that initially. There's the other Yara. There's still a couple more rooms to clear that I could get Yara runes out of, so that's what we're gonna hope for. I can still get out, luckily. Oh my gosh, Curse of the Maze, please. Oh my gosh, Curse of the Maze, please. I still actually still haven't been to the curse room, or to the secret room. No, I want the damage up from Kerptorm, thank you. Pope Hat. Doesn't really help me much. I probably should have waited to see if a blank card showed up. But so be it. At this point, it wouldn't really help at all. Alright, well, let's, Oh, wait, there's another Yara? Oh my gosh. And a blank rune, which could also be a Yara. But it could also be a Perthro. Just want that knot in the doorway, basically. Before I open stuff, I'm going to defeat Blue Baby. Just because I could drop another rune off that. Could. Not likely, but could. Yep. We found so... That started as one chest. We hardcore pro-throwed that.
Answers.
Algaz will be useful. If I die the first four times against Mega Satan, I will come back for that rune. If I remember. Oh gosh darn it, it switched rooms. Oh, it was a Perthro. Alright. Oh, that's right, I wanted to actually fight Blue Baby first. Might as well take Concussive Tears, it's a damage up. It's a very slight damage up. And a chance to give your enemies the confused debuff. Look, this fight is going to take a matter of seconds, let's be honest here. Well, thank you, game. So I didn't get a rune out of that. Not surprised, but come on, had to try. Now, for the real piece de resistance. I'm not going to Ludovica, I don't think. Oh, I have the model transformation now. Lucky Foot. Piercing, I already have. Oh god, do I dare... I don't know what I'm willing to do here. I really don't. I will Chocolate Milk. Well, that's not useful. I'm just gonna try and very slowly pick these things up. Okay, I've got an HP up, that's nice. I don't want to Dr. Fetus, I think I want to avoid that. I think I also want to avoid Ludovico. I'm curious. Oh my gosh, what am I? Seriously, what am I? I don't know. Or do I just say screw it? No, I'm too worried about Ludovico to actually pick it up. Oh, screw it. Oh, I still fire? Oh god, so when I'm firing up... When I'm firing up, it's just gonna be shenanigans. Because it'll just... Oh gosh darn it. Sorry, I wanted to clear out the pedestals. So I could safely grab this. Okay. My body is ready. Oh, I have a magnet, so... Although, it'll recharge. This is gonna be a fight. I am death. Spawns on the same side. Can I buy you something with my credit card? Well, GG. That is the keeper complete. Noose baby, sail baby, and mega blast. I'll skip this cutscene since it gets so loud. Mega Blast has appeared in the basement. Sail Baby has appeared in the basement. And Noose Baby has appeared in the basement. Those are co-op babies. So, that was amazing. What a run. So, items. What are we missing? I see one. There. Two, three. We are missing three items. And I think that's it. One of those is Mega Blast. I think that's three. But yeah. Whew. What a run. I find it very funny that I was having so much trouble with the Keeper, and then I managed to beat Hush with a Chaos card. Because I presumed that that was one of the only ways to do it, with the Keeper. And then, on top of that, I also go back and do it a second time, getting Boss Rush and Keeper, forgetting Mega Satan. And then in the last time I go back, we get Boss Rush, because why not? Mostly because I had 9 lives. I wouldn't have done it if I didn't have 9 lives. Same with Hush, because I had a goal. But then Hush, and on one hit point, first try, like, one hit, we're gone, and we manage it, which is insane, especially after, you know, I presumed that Chaos card was about it, in terms of ways of defeating him. And then we go on to pseudo-break the game in the chest, because we just found that many Yara runes. And on top of all that, we then defeat Mega Satan. We get the three things that I needed last in one run after getting them each individually in other runs and building up to this one. Wow. I really hope that you guys enjoyed watching this episode. I'm not going to go and say that I'm the best Isaac player ever because I managed to pull this off. There was some luck. There was a little bit of skill, obviously, to some degree, but a lot of it was also dead cat courage. I've got 9 lives. I might as well do something stupid. The Hush was a little risky, I will admit that, because, you know, if you die in Boss Rush, you just... Boss Rush is over. But if you die in Hush, you have to try it again. So, yeah. Was maybe a bad choice, considering I was just going for Mega Satan. But we've got 3 items left. We got 1001% right there looming. I'm excited. I hope you guys are too. I think we're just going to be playing Isaac from here on out to grab those. We've got our donation machine to bring back up to a reasonable level. And then we've got more speedrunning practice. I haven't heard anything from Balls of Steel in terms of announcements. I don't actually directly hear from them for when it's going to resume. But hell, I want to give it a shot. Anyway, I will stop rambling. I hope you guys very much enjoyed this episode. I know I certainly had a blast. There was definitely some intensity to it. What a way to end the Keeper runs. Anyway, I will see you guys next time. But until then, keep your gears turning.